Central Park Reservoir.
The water system.
Pumping goo everywhere.
Adding more and more people to the hive mind.
If all those symbiotes get out of Manhattan...
Goodbye, Earth. Hello, planet goo. The meteorite is the source of all the power, right? Creating goo, creating symbiotes. But it was useless until Harry repaired it.
Yeah.
And that particle accelerator is what damaged it in the first place. Cut off a piece at low power.
Right, so what if we crank the power up? Like way past 11?
Might destroy it.
And free everyone connected to the hive mind.
Theoretically.
But that reservoir's gotta be mobbed with symbiotes. And you know Harry's not gonna let that rock out of his sight.
Unless he sees something he wants more. Me. Just, you know, for illustrative purposes. Harry's still Harry. He thinks he's healing the world. But the dream isn't complete without...
his best friend beside him.
I can lead Harry away from the meteorite.
And I can handle all the symbiotes.
While I grab the space rock. For illustrative purposes.
All right. Fire up the accelerator. No more hive mind. World saved. We all get churros?
Theoretically.
Pete, what Connor said about Harry being too far gone. If you can't save him, are you
ready? It won't come to that. You two will be able to destroy the rock in time. Let's heal the world.
For real this time. Somewhere in that thing?
So are Harry and his friends.
Here. I figured you could use a sonic touch.
They're just standing there. What are they waiting for?
Look. I can't thank you both enough. For everything.
Come on, bro. We're the Spider Team.
Don't anyone forget it.
Hey, buddy! You gonna sit in there and play with your pet rock all night? It's you and me, Harry. Like we always wanted.
Story, Watson. What was that? Dead end? No. There has to be a way in. Oh. Whoever dropped these flares. I hope they made it out. Meteorites connected to the rest of the hive. Just a normal rock. I can also end the world. Alive. Gotta get out of here. If I get this rock back, it's game over. Looks like my exit's just past that chopper.
Sure, your plus one isn't invited to our high school reunion, Harry! Harry! Through. Flash kicking our asses for 4 years?
We were weak then.
But we had each other!
Thank you.
single day after school! Even slept over after your mom got scared! Your mom got sick!
We couldn't see her like that.
When you lost her, that day on the football field, I was there! Always have been!
Until we got sick again. Abandoned us while we were fighting for our lives.
I was trying to save you!
Didn't feel like that to us. We're giving you a chance, Pete.
Dropping in. Stay calm. Take them out one at a time. Get free Harry with more anti-venom. This anti-venom's gonna sting, Harry! More anti-venom!
for you, for everyone. We gave you everything you ever wanted, and you threw us away.
I should have been better. I'm so sorry.
Then you replaced us with Miles. We poisoned you. Why do you keep fighting us?
You're not giving me a choice!
Whoa, symbiote's dropping in.
We can free Harry with more antivenom! Not working! Venom's gonna sting, Harry!
Thank you.
I'm never gonna heal the world with you! Not like this!
The meteorite. You took it from us.
Now.
You're holding Pete back.
That's why you pushed us apart.
Maybe
Maybe I was, but Pete wasn't Pete.
Thank you. I'm done. Either way, Pete.
No, no, no. We still have time.
No, we don't. It'll kill them. And then it'll kill you. Let's heal the world, Pete. Together.
I'm sorry.
Give me some room. If it's gonna work, but I gotta try.
Harry.
Pulse is weak. We gotta move.
What have you done? What have you done to him?
I'm so sorry.
I'm coming with you. Wait.
There are traces of brain activity, but his chances of coming back are very slim.
Just keep him alive. Get the G-Serum ready. ASAP.
For the last few years, tragedy has tried to tear the city apart. But we somehow kept going. We battled sickness, evil, cataclysm. We are tired, anxious, stressed, numb. But we have never lost hope. The city needs to heal. We're all ready to return to normal, but what is normal? What if it no longer exists? Over the last half hour, I've talked about how these events have changed me. But what about you? In this ongoing series, I will be talking with people throughout the city, exploring our new behaviors, new routines, new thoughts and feelings. I hope you'll join me on this journey. This has been Mary Jane Watson, and you're listening to The New Normal. Episode one, done.
Nice.
I don't know.
Ooh, he's good to go.
In a minute, I want to show you something first.
Okay.
It has molasses in it.
Yum, I'll take those.
Thanks again for the donation, Peter. Have you talked to Miles about?
Not yet.
You ready?
Miles. I've been meaning to talk to you about something. I mean, I have been talking to you all the time. It's great to talk. So many good talks. I just haven't been talking to you about what I should have been talking to you about.
Pete.
Let me start again.
I got this. All of it. Go be Peter Parker for a while.
Are you sure? It's a big city.
I can handle it. As long as I can still call you for advice.
You don't need it.
Maybe not now, but there'll come a time.
I'm here for you. Always.
Hey, bro.
I'll be really quick because I know that there's going to be a cutscene, credit scene coming up. That was a great game. I know that Peter Parker is coming back for the third game. That's obvious. But one thing that I wanted to mention is that I just thought it was a little short. I mean, maybe not a lot of you agree. The story is fine the way it is. It's just, I wish it was a little bit more Miles Morales story side to it. It just doesn't seem like there's a lot of Miles Morales in it. It seems like it's mostly Peter, which is understandable because it's Spider-Man. And Peter is the first Spider-Man. And there is a lot of Miles Morales in it. So the story is about 15 hours long, about, give or take. I think this is going to be a very, like, I'm just surprised. This is going to take me like less than 20 episodes. And I was expecting at least 30, maybe 40. So it kind of sneaks up on you, the ending, because it kind of goes by quick. I mean, of course, you do the side quest, it prolongs it, but it's kind of weird that are they like showing what could happen in the future? Not sure. But anyways, so yeah, it was really good. I enjoyed it. It's one of my favorite games. It's the side quests are lacking. The first game, there's a lot of side quests, and it was really good. The only thing I didn't like about the first game was there are too many repetitive crime segments that you had to figure out and everything like that. If you can hear the music in the background, my bad. Sorry. And I didn't like that. And I'm guessing that the G serum he's talking, Osborn is talking about is the Golem serum. The Goblin. He's going to become Goblin. My precious. No, sorry. The Goblin serum. Yeah, well, he's not calling it the Goblin serum, obviously. But yeah, it was good. It was a great game. It was excellent. I gave it a 9.5 out of 10. I would probably go down to a 9.2 or 9.3. The only thing I did not like was the length of the side quest. It would just seem like there was like only 10 side quests and that's it. I wish there was more side quests to do for the city of New York. But it kind of was obvious that they were going over budget, and the game looks excellent. Everything's excellent. and everything just went into budget for the main story. And it just looks like they had to hurry it up and they were rushing it. And they, so they cut short some ideas. I think Miles Morales shows up with a new costume near the end. No explanation. He just says new threats. There's not even discussion. I think that was cut out, or maybe I didn't do something. I don't know. But I am going to go back and finish. I'm going to have probably one more episode clean up for Platinum, but probably not. So, yeah. So, anyways, that was great. That was a good game. 9.5 out of 10. I highly recommend it. Or 9.3. I'm not sure. I need to mull over. The game was just, oh my gosh, it's just amazing. The main story is amazing. Like I said, side quest. There's a lot of side quests. There's not a lot of side quests. There's major side quests, excuse me, that could lead up to the third game, but it was just lacking, I thought. I wanted a little bit more. Anyways, that's going to do it for me. I hope you guys enjoy. Let's just watch the rest of the credits and also the end credit scene. All right.
What do you want?
The Spider-Men. You know who they are, don't you?
Why?
They ruined my son.
We all have to experience loss. Even you, Norman.
What are you writing?
The final chapter.
Hi. I hope you're hungry. Food's almost ready. Why don't you go show her your essay? He worked so hard on it.
Some guy in Harlem, probably seen him volunteering in the city, helping out his city council mom, and trying to live up to his hero dad. Yeah.
This is Albert.
Hi. Nice to meet you. Oh, and this is my daughter, Cindy.
What's up, New York?